Hi friends, my name is Bhushan, back again with another video. In our previous lecture, we have discussed how to develop a login application in JavaFX. So in this video series, we will look at the database operations in JavaFX, which means we will learn how to insert a record into database and how to update the record and how to delete a record and how to search the records. And also we will look at how to display the records in a table view. So I hope this entire video series will be interesting and you will learn a lot of things. So before start developing the application, let's look at the demo of the final application that we are going to develop. So I will jump into my source folder and I will double click on this executable jar file, and this will display a main window. So for the sake of this video series, I'm going to use a single window to perform all the operations. You can use a multiple windows if you want. In my previous lecture, I have discussed how to use a multiple windows in JavaFX. So let's add a records to our application. Michael Schofield, Michael at gmail.com. So when I click add employee, the record will be stored into database and also the record will be displayed in a table view. So as you can see, so let's add one more record. Sarah at gmail.com. Click on add employee, the record will be stored and also the record will be displayed in a table view. As you can see, for every action in the console, you can see the messages. So when I inserted a record in the console, it will display it as employee inserted. So if I delete any one of the record, and it will display the employee ID, something the deleted. So let's look at the update operation. So if you want to update any one of these record, you can update it. But for the sake of this video series, I'm going to update an email ID. So let's update the email ID of Sarah. So the Sarah's employee ID is 12 and his new email ID is sarah123@yahoo.com. So when I click update, the record has been updated. As you can see in the result console, the text will be displayed as email has been updated for employee ID 12. So if you want, you can delete the record. If I want to delete any one of the record, then you have to type the employee ID. So the employee ID is 7. And when I click on delete, the record has been deleted. And again, in the result console, you can see the message. If you want to display a particular record in a table view, then you have to specify the employee ID, which is 12, and when you click search, the particular record will be displayed in a table view. And again, in the result console, you can see the message. And if you want to search all the employees' records, just click on this search all employees button. It will display all the employees' records. So, and if you want to hide any one of these columns, then just click on this little plus mark and it will show all the column names. If you want to hide any of the columns, just click on this. The ID column will be hidden. So if you want to display it again, just click on this. The column will be displayed. So that's all about this application. It's a very simple application and I have not done any validation. As we go further, if we get a time, we will add a validation to this application. So thank you so much for watching this video. From next video, we will start developing this application step by step. So stick to this video series. I will see you in next video. Thank you.